طيب، بسم الله والحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، after praising Allah سبحانه وتعالى and sending the salutations upon the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام and upon his family and his companions and upon all those who follow, upon his guidance into the establishment of the last day. To proceed, ikhwan, فَسُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. Glory belongs to you, Ya Allah. Verily we have no knowledge except that which you have taught us. And indeed you, Ya Allah, you are the all-knower, the all-wise. You are the all-knower and the all-wise. Allahumma inna نعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع ومن قلب لا يخشع ومن نفس لا تشبع ومن دعاء لا يسمع. Verily, Allah, we seek refuge with you from knowledge that has no benefit, and from a heart that has no fear, and from a soul that has no satisfaction or contentment, and from a dua that goes unanswered, and from a dua that goes unanswered. To proceed, ikhwan, فنواصل معكم في هذه الليلة المباركة الكريمة عونا من الرحمن الرحيم. So we continue in this blessed and noble night of ours, seeking the aid of our Lord, the most merciful and the most compassionate. مستفيدين طيب مذكرا نفسي وياكم, reminding ourselves firstly, and our brothers and our sisters and our children secondly. مستفيدين ومتعلمين من كتابي شيخنا أبي عمر عبد الكريم الحجوري حفظه الله تعالى. As we continue to learn together and educate ourselves together and benefit ourselves with one another, reading from, learning from the words or one of the books of our Sheikh, who's known as, what's the author's name, Ya Ikhwan? And the man who can...
Abu Amr Abdul Kareem
Al-Hujuri. He's from the Hujuri tribe there in Yemen. طيب فقبل أن نبدأ هذا الدرس, before we begin tonight's lesson, يا إخوان, من يذكر لنا فائدة تعلمناها قبل. Who can mention, before we start, a benefit that we learned in the last lesson? تفضل شيخ. لا بأس, تفضل. ما شاء الله تعالى. قولوا غفر الله لك. We learned the statement, the dua, غفر الله لك. غفر الله لك. ترجم هذا الدعاء لنا. Translate that dua for us. What does it translate to mean?
May Allah forgive you.
May Allah forgive you. I sent. طيب وفائدة ثانية. Another benefit.
At-tawheed is the verbal noun from the word wahada, which means to make something one.
Allahu Akbar. تعلمنا معنى توحيد. وهذا أهم من كل ما تعلمناه قبل. والله أعلم. والله أعلم. So we also learned, and this was the best that we learned so far, and Allah knows best. We learned the meaning of التوحيد. وهذا مهم. And that's important, يا إخوان. ما معنى التوحيد? What does توحيد mean? تعلمنا أن التوحيد المصدر من فعل واحد, أي أن يجعل شيئا واحدا. We learn what? That توحيد is the verbal noun derived from the verb wahada. Wahada, which means
to make something one.
توحيد is the verbal noun derived from the verb wahada, which means to make something one. فهذا الفعل الأول تعلمناه. So this is the first verb that we learned. What's the verb, يا إخوان? واحدة. واحدة. واحدة means to make something one. طيب نبدأ إن شاء الله تعالى. We'll start بإذن الله تعالى. وقبل ذلك أعطيتمونا واجبا وهو إعطاء الهدية لشخص. إعطاء الهدية لشخص. And we had another part of homework, and that was from someone, or everyone inshallah, or most of us inshallah, to to give a gift to someone. For someone to come and give a gift to his brother, or for one of our sisters to come to themselves and give a gift to one of the sisters. فَمَنْ فَعَلَ هَذَا So who did that, Yaquan? Who brought a gift for their brother? MashaAllah. Ace, مَا هَدِيَتُكَ What's your gift? وَلِمَنْ تُعْتِيَهَا And who are you giving it to? So tell me what your gift is and who you're giving it to. Okay, a book of Quran, Labat. And who are you giving your book to, your gift to? Pick one of the brothers and give him your gift. Who else, ya ikhwan? Ma hadiyatuka, what's your gift?
Izar and the Kufi.
MashaAllah, Izar and the Kufi gave it to Sheikh Naeem. Allahu Akbar. Fortunes
of the Muslims.
Fortunes of the Muslims. No. Give your gift to someone, Ikhwan. We have two new children, Ikhwan. Masmuka, Yahi. What's your name, man? Sinai. Sinai, how old are you?
Nine.
Allahu Akbar. What had Akhuka? That's your brother.
Yes.
What's your name, man? Huh?
Ramain.
What kind of umruka anta? How old are you?
Six.
Anta Jaditsa? You're new to? Mm-hmm. What's your name also? How old are you? Maratan Thaniatan? Say it again. Jobri?
No.
I said that wrong?
Yes.
Say it again.
Gilbert.
Tayyip, and you're 11. Yes. Allahu Akbar. Tayyip, akhir man yu'ti hadiyatan ya akhwan li shakhs. One last person to give a gift to someone. Atayta bi hadiya? You came with a gift?
No.
Abdurrahim? Hadiya?
I got one.
So, you new today also? Ta'al indana, inshallah. Come to the class. May Allah bless you. Got a gift, طيب ما هديتك؟ What's your gift?
A rug,
mashallah ta'ala. طيب آتي هديتك لشخص. Give your gift to someone, يا إخوان. One of our sisters also, from the sisters, give your gift to one of the sisters. If you came with a gift, may Allah bless you all. طيب نبدأ إن شاء الله تعالى في هذا الدرس. So we continue, inshallah, with tonight's lesson, يا إخوان. طيب أكتب هذا. Write this down, يا إخوان. أقسام التوحيد. Aqsamu at-tawheed. You brothers online, write this category down. Aqsamu at-tawheed. Categories of at-tawheed. Categories of tawheed. C-A-T. How am I spelling it, ya akhwan? C-A-T-O-G. Categories.
Of Islam.
Categories of Islam. Or you could put tayyib. Afwan. Categories of Tawheed, not Islam. Categories of Tawheed. T-A-U, or you can say W. H-E-E-D. For our new children, ya ikhwan, man yusallimu lahuma waraqatan aw qalaman liyaktubu biha, or liyaktubu bihi. For our new children, ya ikhwan, who can give them something to write with? In a piece of paper also. May Allah bless you all. طيب أقسام التوحيد. Categories of التوحيد. تعلمنا ما معنى توحيد قبل. We have learned previously, bihamdulillah, the meaning of توحيد. Ace. ما معنى توحيد. What does توحيد mean? Without looking at your notes. Oneness of Allah. You can say that. We gave an easier definition. What did you learn last time?
The
what did you learn about Tawheed? It's the verbal noun. Derived from the verb wahada, which means to make something one. طيب أقسام التوحيد. Categories of Tawheed. طيب العلماء يختلفون في أقسام التوحيد إلى قولين. إلى قولين. The scholars of Islam, they differ. The scholars of Islam differ into two opinions.
Right
there? Not yet. لا بأس. إذا تريد تكتب فكتب. وهذا أحسن. If you want to write, then write. That's the best. ولا تخلوا يا إخوان نفسي أن أخبركم متى تكتبوا. لا. أكتبوا الفوائد كما تكتبوا. تسمعونها كما تسمعونها. Also, يا إخوان, even myself. Don't wait for me to say, write this down. Don't wait for me to say, write this benefit. لا. You write what you hear to the best of your ability. والكاتبون أقسام. And the people who write, the students of knowledge who take notes are on different levels. Are on different levels. فالأولى هو الذي يكتب ماذا كلما يسمع. كلما يسمع. The best note taker, inshallah, all of you, Gilbert, the best note taker is the one who what? He writes down everything he hears. Allahu Akbar. He doesn't wait till someone to say, hey, write that. لا هو يكتب. He's already writing. إذا يقوله المدرس أو لا هو يكتب. If the teacher or the person who's sharing the benefit says write down or not, Gilbert is already writing. Allahu Akbar. وهذا هو الأول. That's the best. عبد الرحيم, his hand never stops. الحمد لله. طيب والثاني هو أدنى من الأول, and he is at a lower level than the first. هو الذي يكتب الفوائد. العلم الجديد. العلم الجديد. The second note taker, he's under the first. He's the one that does what? He only writes whatever knowledge is new for him. If he knew that already, he doesn't write it. He's not like the first student. The first student is the best. If he knows it or not, mashallah, he's writing. He's the best. He's going to get everything. Allahu Akbar. Take the knowledge home to his family, his child, his wife, her husband. He's going to share the benefit. Second level, writes down whatever is new. Third level, third student, third writer, هو الذي ينتظر حتى يقال له اكتب ثم يكتب. وفيه خير أيضا ولكن الخير فيه قليل. الخير فيه قليل. The third note taker is the one that he's not really writing. He's waiting. He's about to write. His pen is always about to write. Like the guy who starts fights and never fights. Hold me back, man. He's like that guy. And nobody's really holding him. He's always about to write. Then when the teacher says, write this down, he writes. He only writes, that's most of us, especially in America. He doesn't write until the teacher says, hey, write. Then he writes, oh, mashallah. And then alas, he's the one, الذي لا يكتب شيئا. He doesn't write anything. ولكن كأنه يكتب حتى لا يضحك عليه في الدرس. And the last writer, the last student, he's the one not writing anything. But he doesn't want to be laughed at. So he's in the class as if he's writing. Maybe he's drawing house, circles, squares, Batman, Robin, whatever. He looks like he's writing. He doesn't want no one to say, hey, you're not writing. So even myself, I try to say, write. Get this benefit. Don't let this pass you by. But don't wait for me to say that. You write whatever you have the ability to write. And of course, everyone's on different levels. طيب العلماء يختلفون يا إخوان إلى قولين بالنسبة إلى أقسام التوحيد. So the scholars differ into two statements, two opinions regarding how many categories of tawheed are there. So what I want you to write is categories of tawheed. Next line, the scholars differ. Your chapter is what? Categories of tawheed. You're going to write what? The scholars differ. Ila qawlain. Into two opinions. Scholars differ into two opinions. Abdurrahim, iqra alladhi katabta. Read what you write. You have wrote. You have written. Read the chapter and what you wrote. What did you write so far? Abdurrahim, sir? Inshallah. Categories of Tawheed, the scholars differ. Read what you have. Alhamdulillah. Ila qawlain. Right? The scholars differ into two opinions. Gilbert, iqra alladhi indaka. Read what you write, what you have written. Oh, your pen broke. طيب. من يعينه يا اخوان? Who can help him out? Iqra alladhi indaka, Shaykh. Read what you have written.
Categories of Tawheed. The scholars differ in two matters. The first, Talib writes down all things.
Oh, that
The second only writes
The sheikh jammed the benefits together. That happens, yeah.
The third is the one who always about to write. He writes when instructed. Mm. The fourth doesn't write anything. The scholar's difference in two opinions.
طيب جميلا هذا خير. That's tremendous. He just اختلط ألف وائد. He just can put the benefits together. So go back to the beginning when you wrote categories of Tawheed.
Categories of Tawheed, the scholars differ in two matters.
طيب, into two opinions.
Two opinions.
Period. Then skip a line and write benefit over that second category. Oh, yeah. That second paragraph.
I think that I separated.
May Allah bless you. Yeah. I sent. طيب, last person, ya Shaykh. Sahib al-Adidas. Our brother, I forget your name. Moi, طيب, the brother that has a nice Adidas hoodie. I like Adidas, yeah, Khwan. طيب, اقرأ الذي عندك. Read what you have written. Moi.
Okay, categories of Tawheed, the scholars differ into two different opinions.
MashaAllah. You guys with me, Gilbert? And your brothers? One more time. Your name again?
Sinai and
Omaya. Sinai and Omaya. طيب, Ace, and Tamai, you with me? طيب. العلماء يختلفون إلى قولين. The scholars differ to two opinions. القول الأول, the first opinion. Write this down, إخوان. First opinion, أن قسامه ثلاثة. Is that the categories of توحيد are three. So you should have the categories of توحيد. The scholars differ to two opinions. First opinion is the categories of Tawheed are three. You guys with me? Categories of Tawheed. The scholars differ to two opinions. Some scholars say there are three. Not every scholar says that. First opinion is that the number or the categories of Tawheed are three. And most scholars say that. Second opinion is what? Close. Not two, but four. Not two, but four. One of our scholars had that opinion. And his sheikh, Sheikh Ibn Abbas, also had that opinion. First opinion is what? The categories of Tawheed are, Gilbert, how many? Three. Second opinion, the categories of Tawheed are four. So what are you going to have? The scholars differ. Some scholars say three. Some scholars say four. Easy. You guys with me? How many categories of Tawheed?
First opinion is three. Mm. Second opinion is four.
MashaAllah. The scholars differ. First opinion is three. Second opinion is four. Some scholars say three. Some scholars say four. You guys with me? Next benefit. وَهَذَانِ لِقَوْلَانِ قَوْلٌ وَاحِدٌ. And this is going to throw some of you off. Right. Whoever does not get this owes me 10 push-ups at the end of class. Right. Whoever does not get it. If Qawi doesn't get it, Gilbert doesn't get it, Brother James doesn't get it, mashallah. We can work out as Muslims, ya khwan. Inshallah, it's recommended to be in shape. Right. If you don't get it, you owe me 10. Not now. Ba'da ad-dars. After class. Right. Next point. It's going to sound tricky, but it's easy, inshallah. طيب, next point. You should have categories of Tawheed. The categories of Tawheed, the scholars differ into two opinions. First opinion is that there are three. Second opinion is Gilbert, they are four. Next benefit, skip a line. Now you're going to write, these two opinions are one and the same. These two opinions are one and the same. Are the same. These two opinions are the same. Some scholars say three, some scholars say four. Next benefit was these two positions. What's the first position, Brother James?
That's the categories of Tawheed are three.
Allahu Akbar. Second position?
Categories of Tawheed are four.
Allahu Akbar. Next benefit, these two positions are one and the same. Nafsul ma'na, have the same meaning. Have the same meaning. You with me, Abdul Rahim? Some say three, some say four. In reality, what they're saying is the same. How is that? When you break it down. Tell them.
When the fourth opinion is inside of the third opinion for the people that believe is three opinions.
Super close. But on the same, on the right boat. Allahu Akbar. He's right there. Some say three. Some say four. In reality, they're saying the same thing. How is that? Super close. You're right there with our beloved brother Elijah. Allahu Akbar. You're on the same safina. You're on the same boat. Alhamdulillah. Going down the Nile in Egypt. Tayyip. So we'll get to that inshallah ta'ala. What you should have is the scholars differ to two opinions. First opinion is the categories of Tawheed are how many? Asad? Three. Second opinion? Moi? There are four. Next benefit, this first opinion and second opinion is the same. One and the same. طيب. Now how is that? الذين يقولون أن قسامه ثلاثة كلها لله. Those that say that the categories of Tawheed are three, all three of them are talking about Allah. والذين يقولون أن قسامه أربعة هذا الرابع للنبي. Those that say the categories of Tawheed are four, the first three of this four are the same as the first three. Therefore Allah. And the fourth one, they're not talking about Allah at all. They're talking about singing the Messenger of Allah out and following. So in reality, they have the first three categories the same. They add one more category, not talking about Allah, but they single out the Prophet of Allah and following. We'll learn that inshallah. Uktubu hadha. Write this next thing down. Skip a line, ya ikhwan. Al-qismu al-awwal. Category number one. Category number one. Category number one. Category number one. Tawheedu al-rububiyyah. أنا أنطقه وأنتم تنطقونه بعدي. I'll say it, you say it after me. أنا أنطقه وأنتم تنطقونه بعدي. I'll say it, you say it. I'll say it, you say it. القسم الأول. القسم. القسم. الأول. القسم الأول. First category. القسم الأول. توحيد. توحيد. الربوبية. الربوبية. توحيد. توحيد ما شاء الله ما شاء الله توحيد الربوبية الربوبية الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر توحيد. Raise your voice up. Make your voice like my voice. Tawheedu al-rububiyyah. Al-rububiyyah. Allahu Akbar. Your younger brother. Tawheedu al-rububiyyah. Al-rububiyyah. Allahu Akbar. Asad. Tawheedu الربوبيه الله اكبر تفضل توحيد الربوبيه Al-Rububiyyah. MashaAllah. Gilbert. Tawheedu. Al-Rububiyyah. Al-Rububiyyah. Allahu Akbar. What's your name again, Yahi? Damir, mashallah. Tawheedu. Al-Rububiyyah. Allahu Akbar. Brother James.
Tawheedu. Al-Rububiyyah.
Allahu Akbar. Moi.
Tawheedu. Al-Rububiyyah.
Allahu Akbar. Lil-Wajib. Uridukum an taktubu hadha al-ism wa ta'rif 10 marrat. First part of tonight's homework. To write this title down 10 times. You get home, you're going to write it. Tawheedu. Al-Rububiyyah. Tawheedu Al-Rububiyyah. وَعِندَمَا تَكْتُبُونَهُ تَنْتِقُونَهُ. And while you're writing it, say it. It's going to help your Arabic tremendously. The goal is not just to write it. Where's our goal, ya ikhwan? We're writing, inshallah. What's the goal? To write it 100 times? That's just the goal?
To learn.
To memorize it, to learn it. Writing is what? It's just a tool. It's just a wasila. Just a means. Like getting your car to come to the masjid to pray. Your goal is what?
Pray.
To go pray. The car is just a wasila. It's just a means to get you there. Suppose you jog. Alhamdulillah. Same goal. Suppose you walk. Same goal. Uber. La bas. The bus. The train. Same goal. My goal is what? To get to the masjid to worship Allah. How I get there is the wasila. The goal is to memorize, to learn the points. So while you're writing it, some brothers think, when I write it 100 times, I'm done. No, you're not done. If you write it 100 times and you still don't have it, write it 10 more times, 20 more times. You're never going to memorize something unless you write it at least 500 times. Sometimes we think we got it. The brother faces the Qibla, recites the surah, he says the page 50 times. Alhamdulillah, that's good. He doesn't have it yet. He thinks he has it. He thinks. Mu'ayy sits there, recites the hadith. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. Actions are based upon intentions. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. Actions are based upon intentions. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. Actions are based upon intentions. 25 times. 25 times. Alhamdulillah. He thinks he has it. He doesn't have it yet. It's in his short-term memory. Your memory is broken down into two parts. Short-term, long-term. Short-term, long-term. Many of the scholars of psychology, many of them, they say, you're never going to transfer anything from your short-term memory except with a lot of repetition. It's impossible. So overseas in Saudi and Africa especially, in Yemen, they have the children especially. Any memorizer is going to say it at least 100 times. And then he's not done. Tomorrow, 75 times. He's not done. The next day, 50 more times. That's why those scholars over there are holding Sheikh Abdul Mursin, Sheikh Ibn Abbas, the big Sheikh, the Sheikh of our Sheikh, the Sheikh, huh? Oh, bigger than Sheikh Fawzan. It's a name that in America, unfortunately, لأننا على الأسف نحن من الأجانب نحن مساكين لا نتكلم العربية ما عندنا العلماء. Many of us, we're miskeen, we're poor. We're in America. We have no scholars. We don't speak the language. We don't contact the ulama. That's something we have to bring back. Now that this blessed place is open, maybe we'll start back the telelinks again. When you contact the ulama. Not just to ask them, Sheikh, can I refute this brother? Not only that stuff, ya ikhwan. When we contact the scholars for knowledge. Allahu Akbar. My son has been disbehaving. How can I reprimand him, ya Sheikh? Allahu Akbar. We have 5 new Muslims in the community. What's your advice? The scholars love that, ya ikhwan. Tayyib. So many of us don't really know who the ulama are. And that's our beloved brother, Abu Sa'id, Abu Sajid goes overseas. He comes back home and teaches us who his scholars were. So now we learn who the scholars were from our beloved brother. This brother goes to Yemen. This brother goes to Egypt. This brother goes to Morocco. We never knew there were scholars there. He learned from those scholars. He comes back home and says, in Yemen, there are scholars there. Who are they? This sheikh, this sister, this sheikh, and this sheikh. So now I'm learning who the scholars are. But many of us have not made the trip, have not met a scholar. So we don't really know. طيب. So this name here, memorize this name, ya ikhwan. One of the greatest memorizers still alive with us today. طيب. His name is Sheikh Muhammad Ibn Ali Ibn Adam, Ethiopian, from Africa. Holden. MashaAllah, ya ikhwan. Holden. Muhammad Ibn Ali Ibn Adam. Write this name down. One of the greatest scholars of today. One of the greatest memorizers of today. Memorized almost every hadith book out. Allahu Akbar. And he's an old man. He still teaches Bukhari from his memory today. Allahu Akbar. It's a blessing. Ta'ib. So for homework, I want you to write this category. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Especially you children. Learn how to say it. While you're writing it, say it. Tawheedu al-Rububiyyah. Tawheedu al-Rububiyyah. Tawheedu
Surah At-Tawbah.
Surah At-Tawbah. Surah At-Tawbah. The brother's talking about the Mudaf Ilayh. When the first noun doesn't have Alif Alam, second noun has Alif Alam, and you join them together. You say Tawheedu al-Rububiyyah. When you get it together, you say it like it's one word. Tawheedu al-Rububiyyah. That's going to come later. Right? Tell you how to write it. T-A-U-H-E-E-D. Skip a space. A-R dash R U B U Rubu B B I Y Y A H Al-Rububiyyah. So for homework, I want you to write it 10 times. While you're writing it, you're going to do what? Say it. Don't just write, la, la, la. You want to study Arabic too. Write it, say it. Tawheedu al-Rububiyyah. One. Tawheedu al-Rububiyyah. Two. Tawheedu al-Rububiyyah. Three. So who can say it, Ikhwan? Without looking? Tawheedu
al-Rububiyyah.
MashaAllah. Gilbert. MashaAllah. Tafadha. Allahu Akbar. MashaAllah. Tayyip, ikhwan. Ma huwa? What is it? Tayyip. Nu'arrifuhu qabla. Tayyip. Nu'arrifuhu qablan. Thumma nutarjimuhu. If you notice, we didn't translate it yet. It's not important, the translation. We said that when I first met you, brothers. There's a difference between the meaning of something and the translation of something. Tayyip. There's a difference between the meaning of something and the translation of something. Just because you can translate it doesn't mean you know the meaning. Anybody can be a translator, and I'm not knocking anyone. That's not my Islam. I try my best not to talk about people, ya ikhwan. I try my best. I'd rather be the one getting talked about. I can forgive. No problem. طيب. Easy to be a translator. Don't intend to be a translator. La. Don't make that your intention. La, 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 abadan. We mentioned a principle from before in the first class. The Salaf used to have high what? Muay. The Salaf used to have high, without looking at your notes. What do you say when you don't know? Allah, I don't know. Allah, Adam. La, adidi. All right, Brother James, the Salaf used to have what? Huh? High?
No, I'm saying I don't know.
Oh, lab bats. One more time.
Damir.
Damir, I like that name too. The Salaf used to have what? I don't think you were here. Tayyip Gilbert. Labas. Elijah.
High aspirations.
High goals. High aims. They didn't intend, I'm going to intend, all I want to do is learn my Aleph Bata. That's it? No. They intended to learn Arabic. They intended to be scholars, memorizers, students of knowledge, imams, pious, righteous. Don't have low aspirations. La, that's the Christianity, Ikhwan. And we're not talking about them, but al-haqqu wa haqqun yutaba'. The truth has more right to be followed. The truth has more right to be followed. We're not talking about them. They're Christians. They believe what they believe. Their belief is not correct. At any rate, it's from Islam to have high goals. I want to be a translator. No, dig deeper. I want to be an imam. Allahu Akbar. I want to be a scholar. Why can't you intend to be a scholar? Why can't you? Why? It's allowed. It's recommended. Have high goals. The same one that made Imam Ahmed this great memorizer can make you this great memorizer. Many of the scholars in Yemen, this will blow your mind, didn't complete high school. Many scholars in Yemen didn't complete high school, but went on to memorize Bukhari, Muslim, Abu Dawud, Nasa'i, the Quran. Didn't complete high school. Allahu Akbar. Why can't our children memorize? Our child can be one of the greatest memorizers if Allah Ta'ala sees fit. He's the same Allah. لَمْ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ آخَرَ لَا أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِنَفْسِ اللَّهِ نَفْسِ الرَّبِّ رَبُّنَا رَبُّهُمْ رَبُّنَا رَبُّهُمْ. They didn't believe in a different Allah. أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ لَا Allah is one. The same Allah we believe in is the same Allah they believe in. So the point is, we can do it. We can try. The same way our children can play the Xbox 3, 4, 5, some of our children, 6 some of them, 7 hours. MashaAllah. The same way many of us, Tupac comes on. Oh, he's at a party. Or whatever his song that he used to like. Hours. Now we can't even sit for 10 minutes and read Quran. A half hour for class. Everyone's antsy. MashaAllah, when's the brother going to shut up? A half hour, an hour, one class a week. It's never going to harm. But we can do it, Ikhwan. One child we met had an impeccable memory. Allahu Akbar. I won't mention his name, that's not important. A young child. Every movie came on, he knew the name of that author, the character, his real name, other movies he was in. His age, like, mashallah, why are you memorizing this? Why not take that great memory and apply it to Quran and Sunnah? We can do it, Ikhwan. Now you can learn some hadith, the men of the chain, some Quran and Sunnah. It can be done. You brothers can be the one. In 1 year, this brother can be an imam. 1 year. 2 years, 3 years. Why can't we raise our own imams? Now communities call us, hey, Ikhwan, we need an imam. Allahu Akbar. We have our beloved brother, Moi. Give him a train ticket, some Zamzam water, put him on a train. Assalamu alaikum. He goes down south, teach the people Quran and Sunnah. It can be done, Ikhwan. So we have high aspirations, high goals, and may Allah Ta'ala bless us. Tayyip. So we didn't translate it yet. You want to say something? We didn't translate it yet. We're going to give the definition first, and then we'll translate it later.
Oh, now I was going to say something about the, like you're saying, being a translator. Correct me if I'm wrong. I look at it like translating, more so giving it a watered down version due to Islam being revealed in Arabic.
You can say that. No language is like Arabic, Ikhwan. The best translation is still not going to be accurate. Like, it's a translation.
Like, for example, copula verbs. You can't.
Yeah, there are many examples, Ikhwan. The brothers mentioned he's correct. The word Rabb, they say in English what? Lord. That doesn't mean that, Ikhwan. It's just a translation, a weak translation. Tayyip, write this down, Ikhwan. First category was what? Tawhidu al-Rububiyyah. Tawhidu al-Rububiyyah. Tayyip, What is Tawheed Rububiyya?
Worship of Allah Ta'ala.
The meaning. Now the translation.
The controller of all affairs, the provider of all for all.
Super close. Tawheed.
Tawheed Rububiyya is that Allah alone creates, sustains, and owns everything in existence.
Allahu Akbar. Jameelan. وهذا تعريف العثيمين وغيره. And that's the definition of the Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen, and other than him. نُعْتِيكُمْ أَسْهَلَ مِنْ هَذَا. We're going to give you an easy definition. We're going to give you an easy definition. طيب, write this down, ikhwan. This will be the last part of tonight's class, inshallah ta'ala. طيب, skip a line. Now you're going to write the meaning of Tawheed Ar-Rububiyya. First category was what? Tawheed Ar-Rububiyya. طيب, Damir. Now you're going to write, what is it? What does it mean? Not the translation. What it means. Tawheed al-Rububiyya. You're going to write Ifradullahi ta'ala fi af'ala. You're going to write to single out Allah, to single out Allah, to single out Allah, to single out Allah in His action. One of the easiest definitions you're ever going to learn. It encompasses what Sheikh Uthaymeen says. Tawheed al-Rububiyya means to single out Allah in His actions. To single out Allah in His actions. ماذا نستفيد من هذا? What do we benefit here? What are we benefiting here? الأول أن الآن نتكلم عن أفعال ربنا ليس أفعال المخلوق. First benefit here, we're not talking about the actions of creation. Not in this category. We're talking about the actions of the Creator. Tawheed al-Rububiyya, you're talking about Allah's actions. So when you say Tawheed al-Rububiyya, it means what? To single out Allah in His actions. What does that mean generally? لا يعمل أحد كعمل الله أبدا. Generally, it means no one can do something the way Allah Ta'ala can do it. That's a lowly way to say it. To single out Allah in Allah's actions. Allah Ta'ala can speak. Allah can speak. You guys with me, Ikhwan? Allah can speak. Ta'i, we'll give you a trick question, inshallah ta'ala. Huh?
Within the kitab, it says Allah astawa over His throne.
Okay.
You single Him out alone. You can't even compare Allah's actions with a bird, like how a bird rides.
You can't compare Allah's actions with anything. You trying to think about, you're already lost. You trying to compare. Allah is like, you're already lost. Your aqidah is weak. If you say Allah is like, the Creator is like, it shows your ignorance. You can't put a like to the Creator. Damir.
When you're talking about Allah, right? People say, like when I took my child, he was like, Allah touched my heart, right?
Okay.
So is that saying like no one can just decide to become Muslim, like they had to have like some type of feeling?
Feeling from who?
Allah.
From Allah. In general, in the language, you may think you're saying the creation is like the Creator. For example, the brother said, speak. Allah speaks. Allah spoke. And Allah speaks. Allah spoke in the past. Allah speaks in the present. And Allah will speak in the future. Mankind speaks. Mankind spoke. And mankind will speak in the future. Tayyip. When you say to single out Allah in His actions, meaning just because mankind speaks and Allah speaks, your mind should never think that mankind speaks the way the Creator speaks. That's kufr. That's disbelief. To single out Allah in His actions mean that Allah is unique, absolute, eternal. Allah is alone. He's one in His actions. That no one can do the action the way the Creator can do it. The Creator can create. He's the all creator. We can create too. Mankind can create. Allah in the Quran mentions that people can create. That's in the Quran. You guys with me? In the Quran, Allah mentions that other people can speak. And Allah speaks. But some people think, so you brothers, since Allah speaks and the creation can speak, the creation speaks like Allah. The Muslims say, la 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 abadan, that's kufr. The Creator is alone. He's absolute in all of his actions. You with me, Damir? You with me, Gilbert? Tayyip? You with me, Ace? Just because the word may be the same, Allah sees. Allah hears. You hear. You see. The Muslim says, the way the Creator sees, the way the Creator hears, is nothing like the creation. Your mind doesn't even imagine that. The clock has a hand. The clock. Tick tock, tick tock. The clock has a hand. You have a hand. A tiger has a hand. A mouse. You know mice? A mouse. You know mice, Gilbert? A roach. You've seen roaches. A roach has a hand. Has legs. We have legs. A clock has hands. The hand of the clock is befitting the clock. The tiger has feet. The tiger's feet is befitting the tiger. We have feet. Allah blessed us with feet. Our feet are not like the feet of the bear. The bear's feet is befitting the bear. Mankind's feet are befitting mankind. So the word may be the same. Allah sees. Mankind sees. When it comes to the creation, it's limited. When you close your eyes, you can't see. I turn out the lights, you can't see. I blindfold you, you can't see. If you can see, you only can see what's in front of you. You can't see what's behind you. When it comes to the Creator, it's limitless. It's absolute. He's eternal. He's unique. He's one. So the word may be the same, but this is the meaning of tonight's homework. To single out Allah and His actions. Meaning what? No one can do the actions of the Creator the way He can do them. He's alone in His actions. Allah sees. Can we see the way Allah sees? Allah sees? This is disbelief to believe that. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ Surah Ash-Shura. Allah says, there's nothing like Him. Nothing. And He is the All-Hearer, the All-Seer. All-Hearer, All-Seer. Allah is the All-Hearer. Meaning what? He hears everything. If Gilbert closed his ears, he can't hear. I put my fingers in my ears, I can't hear. And if I put my fingers out of my ears, I only can hear what Allah gives me the ability to hear. The Creator can hear everything. His hearing is in a manner that befits His majesty. Memorize this point, ya ikhwan. When it comes to Allah, how is it in a manner that befits His majesty? We'll learn that inshallah ta'ala. Tonight you have one part of homework, and that is to write the first category, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, 10 times. What does it mean, Asad? To single out Allah in His actions. You guys with me? The last thing we're going to do is our dua. We learned the dua last week for our new students, Gilbert, mashallah, and Damir. Did any of our children learn the dua from last week? Asad? Ghafar Allahu laka. May Allah forgive you. Tonight's dua, and then we'll stop inshallah ta'ala, is a very eloquent dua. 10 times each. Write this down, you children. And this dua is Akramakallahu. A-K. Ak. A-K. A-K. R-A. Akrama. M-A. You should have A-K-R-A-M-A. Akrama. Skip a space. Kallahu. K-A. 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 L-L. A-H. I'll say it, you say it. I'll say it, you say it. Ak. Ak. Roma. Ak. Roma. Ak. Roma. Allahu. Ak. Roma. Allahu. Now we're going to say it like the Arabs say it. In Arabic? One second. Now we say it like the Arabs say it. We're going to say it together. We learn akrama Allahu. Now najma'ahuma. Now we're going to put them together. Like I'll say, you say it.